That's the question. Do we know the threshold for the stress threshold for, you know, activating autophagy, and when that pushes the mitochondria then to permeabilize and cause cell death? Like, where, for example, with Valter's work in mice, he had done 48-hour fasts, and there was both autophagy and massive apoptosis occurring. So is it just the intensity of the signal that can then say, okay, autophagy is not going to work here, we got to die? Or do we know?
Well, autophagy is induced in most cell types, while apoptosis is occurring in selected cell types. So what Walter has been observing, if I remember well, is destruction of leukocytes, white blood cells, which are very easily to be rebuilt. So the loss of 50% or 75% of leukocytes can be easily repaired in a few days. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And it is a way to adapt the repertoire of immune cells to changing circumstances. It is a way also to inhibit unwarranted inflammatory reactions. So depending on the context, induction of autophagy can be actually a subtle way to avoid excessive inflammation. One example is the so-called sickness response. So a cat or a dog, a human being or a mouse that is sick, that has a bacterial infection, will hide away, avoid light and noise, and will not eat. It's a classical, phylogenetically conserved reaction in most cases of bacterial infection. And so this phenomenon leads to changes in the metabolism, ketone, the production of ketone bodies, the reduction of glucose levels, presumably also induction of autophagy. And altogether, these mechanisms then avoid excessive inflammation that may be lethal. So Ruslan Metsditov published a paper in Cell last year showing that force-feeding mice, or just increasing the glucose levels to a normal concentration, was sufficient to make bacterial infection that otherwise would have been able to cope with lethal.
Wow. So I know in humans too, when we have a bacterial infection, for example, a stomach virus or something that's bacterial of origin, you don't eat as well. So it sounds like it's sort of a protective mechanism.
It is.
That's really interesting. Mm-hmm. I didn't know that.